here's the theory behind the triangle of like. There's a guy named Doug Copp who put out an email that says, don't get under furniture anymore. Duck cover and hold on, or drop cover and hold on, is a bad idea. Because if you get underneath the furniture and this roof collapses, you're going to get crushed by the furniture you're under. So let's work through that. That's not true, by the way. His idea is get next to the furniture, because then when the roof hits it, it'll angle off this furniture and create this, what we call triangle of life. Now, triangle of life is a legitimate urban search and rescue term. That's where we find our victims, by the way, which is just by chance, because there's no way in a million years that any of you in this room, you'd be better off in Vegas, trying to pick out where the angles are going to be. Because you got to be able to tell me what part of the roof is going to come down and where. And by the way, you very, 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 very rarely would ever get a complete roof collapse, especially in California construction. Forget about the rest of the country for 2 seconds and think about the way we build buildings. We're going to talk about that all day today. They're pretty strong. One of the corners may fail. But to have all four walls kick out and the whole roof come down at the same time, highly unlikely. But even if it did, you know what it's going to land on? It's going to land on all these tables and all these chairs. This group here is completely exposed. This is what Doug Copp and the Triangle Life is telling you to do. Don't get under this great wood piece of furniture. Get out here and expose yourself. And what part of their body is exposed? Their spine, the most vulnerable part. And in fact, if you reach back there, it's sitting right at the top. And then when they're arched over like that, that's crazy. And if the roof does fail, it's going to splinter down and spear them in the back. Who would tell their kids to do that? How could he promote this and feel good about it and sleep at night? That's insanity. You know, as a fireman, I used to wear a hard hat. You know, we call it a helmet, made out of polycarbonate. It was just plastic. Probably a couple of grades better than this. But the reality is it saved my bacon more than once. And the reason is because when things fall, they bounce off of that instead of my head. And I want everything that's going on in your room and your environment, your workplace, to bounce off of this and not you.